हेलो, सर्वाइकल स्पॉन्डिलोसिस और नेक पेन, दिस इज समथिंग दैट ऑल ऑफ अस गो थ्रू एट सम पॉइंट ऑफ द टाइम. इट कुड बी समथिंग वेरी टेम्पररी विच लास्ट फॉर अ फ्यू डेज और अ फ्यू वीक्स. इट कुड बी समथिंग दैट कैन लास्ट फॉर मंथ्स टुगेदर और ईयर्स टुगेदर. सो वॉट हैपन्स हियर इज बेसिकली इट इज द डीजनरेशन ऑफ द बोन्स ऑफ द नेक दैट हैपन्स. वाई डज दिस हैपन? Now this essentially happens because of bad postures. Either we are sitting at the desk the whole day without giving it a break and doing computer work, improper sitting and working on the computer. We don't know where to place the keyboard. You keep it far and then you type like this, you're putting pressure. You know, you don't, or you sit like that, you sit in the sofa and do it, you sit in the chair and do it, you sit on the bed and do it. It could also be because of working in the kitchen, bending and working, making chapatis, cutting vegetables for a long period of time, people who do painting work, people who are correcting, teachers who are correcting, people who are sitting in the bank counter and cash, all these people can get cervical spondylosis. Now, what do you do when you get cervical spondylosis? I told you how it comes. Let's forget about what happens inside, how the bones, you know, all that. Let's not get into that. Let's see what we can do about if you have neck pain. Now, one of the most important reasons why you get neck pain is stress. Have you heard of the term called as, that fellow is a pain in my neck? This problem has become a big pain in my neck. The reason is, suppose you have to meet somebody whom you don't like. They come into your room, they sit in front of you, they talk to you. The moment they go out of the room, what is the first thing you do? You stretch. Because without your knowledge, your muscles in the neck, they go into spasm. Neck is the place which absorbs maximum stress. So the muscles of the neck, they go into spasm. When the muscles of the neck go into spasm, they bring the spine together. When the spine comes closer, it puts pressure on the nerves and blood vessels and give rise to pain. So you could be experiencing pain from the neck radiating down all the way to your tips. Some people get it to the shoulder, some people upper arm, some people all the way to the tip. It can also cause numbness. If the blood vessel is getting compressed, you might feel giddy. These are all things which happens with cervical spondylosis. Now, what is the allopathic approach to cervical spondylosis? Number one, they put you on a collar. Number two, they'll give you painkillers. Number three, physiotherapy. Number four, they'll ask you to go in for a surgery. Now, what is a homeopathic approach? Now, the medicines which are prepared by us take into consideration a lot of things. Number one, we take into consideration the stress that causes it and we give something to relax the muscles around the neck. Number two, the muscles help strengthening the muscles around the neck. It relaxes the muscles, it relaxes the nerves, it relaxes the blood vessel, thereby bringing down the pain, bringing down the giddiness, and bringing down the discomfort. So most of these people, they are all the time wanting to, you know, shrug their shoulders, wanting to stretch. They feel a little lethargy. They feel like they are feeling sleepy. They don't feel very active. All these symptoms will come down once you start on the homeopathic medication. Now, once the pain comes down, we suggest you don't stop the medication because we need to strengthen the neck. That takes a little time. Keep continuing the medication for some time and trust me, the pain can completely vanish. What are the do's and don'ts? See, try not to sit continuously and work. Give breaks every half an hourly. Stretch. Keep your position, keep your keyboards properly. Take professional help. Do physiotherapy, which will again help you. I do not recommend the collar. The simple reason being, the collar will make your neck more stiff. Because you've seen people, even after you remove the collar, they're all the time walking like this. You know, that makes the muscles stiff. That's not what you want. What you want is your muscles to be relaxed. The more you're worried about your neck, the more you're going to keep your neck stiff, the more you're going to suffer. Trust me, nothing is going to happen to you. Relax. Leave your neck in a place where it can move around freely. When the neck is moving around freely, the circulation improves, the energy levels improve, and you feel better. Nothing can happen to you. What will happen if you leave it alone? You will just continue to have pain. a little bit of numbness, discomfort. It's a very old saying that people say, if you don't take care of it, you will get paralysis and you will get all that kind of nonsense. Nothing will happen. The more you worry about it, the more you're going to suffer. You need to just chill. Take the medicines regularly. Yes, in the initial stages, you can do physiotherapy, which will help you strengthen the muscles. Keeping a hot pad can help. Now, how do you sleep when you have cervical spondylosis? Now, previously, they used to say, don't use a pillow. What will happen if you don't use a pillow? You are not sleeping on your back all night. You cannot do that. So, you invariably turn to the side. Now, when you turn to the side and sleep without a pillow, you will be dangling your neck. Or you'll put your hand there, it'll cause more numbness here. You need to sleep with a pillow that is thick enough to cover this gap, this particular gap from here to here, so that your head remains like this. If you use a bigger pillow, your neck will be like this. If you use a smaller pillow, your neck will remain like this. So choose a pillow which is like this. And when you're sleeping in your back, try and remove the pillow and sleep for some time. These are simple things that you need to do apart from the medication, which will take care of your neck pain. Now, in Ayurvedic, there are some massages which can help you. You can even try those massages. Go to an Ayurvedic center, ask them to give you some massages, which will improve your, strengthen your muscles around the neck and help you also. Cervical is one of the most commonly treated cases in our clinics and they respond fantastic. In fact, there are people who come only with this complaint of giddiness and we figure out that they've got cervical. We treat it and they're absolutely fine. So the treatment is excellent for cervical spondylosis. Take care, stay safe.